Is that truly you? I cannot believe my eyes. My lord, everyone! Serana has returned.
I guess I'm expected.
I can't believe it. My long-lost daughter returns at last. I trust you have my Elder Scroll.
After all these years, that's the first thing you ask me? Yes, I have the scroll.
Of course,
she has the scroll.
I'm delighted to see you, my daughter. Must I really say the words aloud? Ah, if only your traitor mother were here. I would let her watch this reunion before putting her head on a spike. Now tell me, who is this stranger you have brought into our home?
This is my savior, the one who freed me.
For my daughter's safe return, you have my gratitude. Tell me, what is your name? I am Harkon, Lord of this court. By now, my daughter will have told you what we are. Not just vampires. For centuries we lived here, far from the cares of the world. All that ended when my wife betrayed me and stole away that which I valued most. You have done me a great service, and now you must be rewarded. There is but one gift I can give that is equal in value to the Elder Scroll and my daughter. I offer you my blood. Take it and you will walk as a lion among sheep. Men will tremble at your approach and you will never fear death again. Then you will be prey, like all mortals. I will spare your life this once, but you will be banished from this hall. Perhaps you still need convincing. Behold the power! This is the power that I offer. Now, make your choice. Be still. Awake at last. Good. The power is growing within you, and now you must learn to wield it. A shrine to Molag Bal, the mighty Daedra prince who is father to all our kind. Our power is a blessing from him. It is he who first bestowed the gift of the ancient blood upon me. In an age long forgotten to history, I ruled as a mighty king. My domain was vast, my riches endless, and my power infinite. And yet, as my mortal life neared an end, I faced a seemingly invincible enemy. My own mortality. I pledged myself to Molag Bal, and in his name I sacrificed 1,000 innocents. In reward, he gave everlasting life to myself, my wife, and my daughter, and so I have defeated mortality itself. My blood is potent. At first, the body is overwhelmed by it. After my bite, you collapsed and fell into a slumber. Now your flesh has acclimated to the new blood that courses through your veins. I assure you, no harm was done. In truth, your strength surprises me. Not all mortals can withstand my embrace. With my guidance, you will become a deadly instrument, striking terror into the hearts of mortals wherever you tread. Now listen to my words and do as I instruct. The true power of the ancient blood is found in the form of the Vampire Lord. Assume the mantle of the Vampire Lord, and we will continue. use the power of the ancient blood to transform into a vampire lord. Transform into the vampire lord, and I will teach you more. Use the power of the ancient blood to transform into a vampire lord. In this form, you can drain the life from your foes with your right hand. With your left hand, you can wield the power of blood magic to raise the dead. You can also call upon the powers of night to turn into a swarm of bats and reappear some distance away. Should you... I sense the power. Cease your flight, and we will move on to the next lesson. Good. You are weaker while on the ground, because you cannot access the blood magic. However, the night powers are still yours to command, and your claws are still formidable weapons. Over time, your powers will grow in strength, and you will find new ways to use your gifts. There is much to learn, but if you master the powers of the vampire lord, few enemies will be able to stand against you. There is one last thing you must know. Slaying mortal men with your life drain grants you new night powers and blood magic. I keep a stable of thralls in the castle, should you need to feed like the baser vampires to stave off the sun. That is all I have to teach you. If you wish to be reminded of these lessons, you need only ask. I have a task that will test your new powers. But first, do you have any questions? As a vampire, you will gain new powers, but also a weakness to sunlight. With each passing day that you do not feed, that weakness will become more deadly, but your powers will also become stronger. Feed upon those who are sleeping, and your vulnerability to sunlight will diminish along with your powers. Good. Go and speak to Garen Marethi. Tell him it is time. He will understand.
Sleep.
Well met, sister.
I leave politics to others. I serve the Lord of the Castle.
Shall we get to the next fight?
Thank you.
Imperial business. Be on your way.
Imperial business. Be on your way. Legion's always looking for strong, capable warriors. If you think you've got what it takes, headquarters is in solitude.
I used to be an adventurer like you. Then I took an arrow in the knee.
There are dragons about, traveler. Be warned.
It happened so fast. One minute the dragon was there, the next it was gone. Everything was destroyed.
There are dragons about, traveler. Be warned.
My cousin's out fighting dragons, and what do I get? Guard duty.
What are y'all going to do about it?
How are we supposed to feel safe in our own homes?
Somebody help!
Help!
I'm getting out of here.
This should be good.
Come and do something.
A fight.
Welcome to the Moorside. If you need anything, I'll be around. Good to have a customer. Don't like those eyes you got. There's a bad hunger to them.
Hrogar's house? It burned down not too long ago. It's a real pity about his wife and kid. The screams woke half the town. Most folk won't go near it now for fear it's cursed. Hrogar claims it was a hearth fire. Some folks say Hrogar started it himself.
That's what they say. See, he's living with Alva now. That started the day after the fire. It ain't right moving in with a new love the day after your kin die like that. Aye, our Jarl would sure like to know if he did, though. Might even pay to find out.
Here, take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter. They say Falian of Morthal has studied vampires, Draugr, and all matter of undead.
Slow? No, it just ain't there at all. Few enough reasons to pass through Morthal before the war started. Now, well, let's just say the front door doesn't get much use. Lurbuck? Fancies himself a bard. He pays, so I let him stay. If I had any customers, I'd be worried about him annoying them. But, well, look around. See ya. There ain't much to... Let's sate that appetite, hmm?
A new face. Such a welcome sight in dreary old Morthal. Welcome, friend. Welcome. Don't fret over the gloom. There's nothing to fear. Old Lorebook will brighten your spirits. Just lend him your ear. The good people of Morthal have yet to embrace my talent. An orc follows to the... Fine. Let's trade, then. Malakath, witness our deeds.
So, life has brought you to Morthal, and to me. What purpose this serves, we will no doubt see. Welcome. Hrogar's house fire? Well, he lost his wife and daughter in the blaze. My people believe it to be cursed now. Who am I to gainsay them? Hrogar blames his wife for spilling bear fat in the fire. Many folk think he set the fire himself. Lust can make a man do the unthinkable. The ashes were still warm when he pledged himself to Alpha. On rumor and gossip? No, but you, a stranger, might find the truth for us. Sift through the ashes that others are too fearful to touch. See what they tell you. Should you prove him guilty or innocent, I will reward you. I stand where I have always stood. Here in Morthal. Now is not the time to fight amongst ourselves. I fear dark days approach, and all of Skyrim's strength will be needed. That which is unknown can create unease, even some fear our new resident wizard. As they grow to know him, they will accept him. Time will prove me right. Hrogar's fate is in your hands.
You will not disrespect Jarl Idgrod while in this hall. Do we have an understanding?
It's no secret that Jarl Idgrod is different. It's also no secret that there are rumors about her and her visions. I won't repeat them. And I won't allow them to be spread under this roof. Now you go about your business.
All right, then.
Tamriel is full of wisdom and magic, if one is willing to look for it. Few have their eyes open.
If you've business with the Jarl, I'd ask that you speak to me first. Ah, you saw that, did you? Life in Morthal has been troubled lately. The people are uncertain, restless. Merely look to the Jarl for leadership. There's news of rebellion against the Empire. Strange noises have been heard in the marshes at night. And then, the tragedy with Hrogar's home. The men simply seek wisdom. Everything will be fine. That's what many here wanted. A quiet life in a quiet place, without the noise or the trouble of a city. Now some worry this wizard Falion will foul it all up. All right then. I do what I can to see that Idgrud's time isn't wasted, and that she only has to deal with important matters. Business with the Jarl. I'd ask that you speak to me first.
I have to.
Hail, companion.
Have you seen my mother? I'm still waiting for her to come home. Papa says that I shouldn't keep waiting. Why not? Mama has to come home sometime.
Morthal used to be a quiet place, but then, the world used to make sense. I'm the best warrior in Morthal, and that's no boast. You want me to prove it? I bet 100 gold I can take you, barehanded. Just your own 2 hands. Weapons and magic are out. Now let's see what you got. Come on.
Ha! I found you!
Gods, no! Now that was a punch. You're a real fighter. I like that. You ever need my steel by your side, you just ask. You've been a good friend to me. That, oh well, you know, a bit of this, a bit of that. They haven't made me a guard, even though I've been asking. So I'll take odd jobs, anything that comes along for now. Mm-hmm.
Hey.
You are new to Morthal. We've not spoken before. This is interesting.
If you stand before me to accuse me of sacrificing children or eating the hearts of the dead, you may save your breath! I have done no such thing, nor do I intend to. I simply wish to live my life in peace! The people of Morthal would much rather weave their own horrid tales about my life than simply ask me for the truth. If they choose to fear me in their ignorance, that's their choice, but it will not change what is true. I know many things. I have studied things beyond.